within themselves, they don't have the culture of policies. It's a little bit like doing picture in a jigsaw fashion. And that's my concern, really, here. Is that sort of jigsaw approach the right one for this massive problem that this world has? And it isn't.
I think it's a very challenging question, and there are problems as well as having a like to know what we're doing at our Lincoln Health around digital inclusion agenda, because I'm just aware of some of the work we do across the authorities, that there's a lot of work going on within the NHS and associated bodies to look at digital inclusion and what we can do with people and virtual, maybe like health plans, we go through that. And also linking in the health of work stuff that's actually going on at the moment. One specific area, just as an example, is the taxi sector. We're working across what about the taxi sector on health and wellbeing issues, and we need to bring all the health professionals from across the six regions of the city region together to do that. And I found that really difficult to do them at the moment. And it is that media is getting better. Or have, you know, linking into what you were saying regarding, you know, people's ideas and stuff that we can do that will make a real difference.
Thank you.
actually we put just one lead, the almost the other one, we left the responsibility to that in the organisation, and that's what that thing should be told to the dog. And I give the example of falls prevention. So within our trust, we do a lot of work with nursing homes to help staff and nursing homes have medication regimes to prevent people from falling. So I think there's more things that we are doing, but we need to actually highlight them together. And then when we have those conversations,
and that would be
the Green Up and Gotten Staffers, it was very well prepared and understood for the issues of drugs, but didn't understand the issues about alcohol as much. In as much as it didn't appreciate the lifelong potential of life shortening impact. Yeah, I know he goes to school programs around alcohol violence. So I just do think we need to keep going back with that message, because the parents' pressure around alcohol is so great that they think it's all right. And it seems, and so if you do not need to understand what those far reaching implications are, that has to be to read those messages, go back to that again.
I mean, I think with the alcohol, we've got to look at where we are as a country, you know, and some of the figures are, we are the biggest drinking consumers of alcohol in probably in the whole world, you know, and the biggest growth in that activity, I don't know if you've seen it on the streets of Malawi, is young women drinking alcohol. The young women and women drinking alcohol has increased, and we're outstripping every other country in that now, on the trends, Denmark and what have you. So it's an absolutely massive cultural thing, and it's not just to do with young people, it's to do with everybody, you know, people sitting in this room, everyone. it's everyone's responsibility. It's the stereotyping, isn't it, you know? It's all young people and what have you. But they've learned a lot of that off their parents, because of this massive culture we've got in this country of alcohol. It's a big part of this country's life, if you like. The only time alcohol consumption had ever gone down was in the First World War, when licensed hours were first introduced, and when there was a massive recession in the 1930s. So any work that's being done is always relating to price. And in our supermarkets and in our off licences, the prices are a hell of a lot lower per unit than what they are in our pubs. Pubs are closing, 26 pubs a week are closing throughout Britain. But there's more and more alcohol, Tesco's, Asda, any one of them brands you can name, who are selling alcohol. And they're selling it buy one, get two, for, you know, buy three. And if you buy three, you'll drink three, you know. And it's clever marketing stuff like that, that is half of the course, you know. So just looking at all the aspects of it, it's such a massive problem. And looking at trying to change that culture. And it's like churches, isn't it? You know, people make choices in life. It's about, I suppose, about accepting the reality of the situation.